Anyway, Shabba Ranks might be the king of Jamaican music, but there's a young pretender to the crown. Buju Banton is 19 years old and he's due to appear in this country at the weekend, but he's been banned from his WOMAD performances for fear his lyrics might cause offence. Little Terry went to see him in Jamaica.
Downtown Kingston, Jamaica, for reggae fans like myself, the music capital of the world, and I'm here to meet the latest international reggae newcomer who's going to be a big star, Buju Banton. Hot on the heels of Shabba Ranks, 19-year-old Buju is already a superstar in his native Jamaica, wooing both the downtown and uptown crowds. At number one in the UK reggae charts all summer and going down a storm in the States, he seems all set for international success.
I think if there's 30 million record buyers out there, Buju Banton could get 27 million of them. I mean, his message is very universal.
But the message which Buju brought out of the ghetto and started the Banton ball rolling has aroused only universal outrage. The song in question, Boom Bye Bye, appears to advocate the killing of gay people, and its author is going to have a lot to answer for. Do you actually like the fact that people are talking about your music?
Well, controversy is a thing that sells, you know. Controversy sells. But the real, when I write a tune, I don't sit down and write a tune that a next man should war, you know. I don't have those things in mind, in my thoughts, when I'm putting my songs together, you know. I just deal with love and certain things. I mean, we are the artists that should open the people's eyes, because they listen to us even more than the politician at times. So therefore, I personally feel that we are the one who should educate the public.
Burn him up bad like a old tire wheel. One Buju Banton, your top. They say boom, bye, bye, in a matty boy. Why not promote no matty man, them
are Buju is not the first one who spoke about it. It's like most entertainers spoke about it, but it's only because Buju Umbaibai is kind of popular. And even the Bible spoke about it. Leviticus 18, so all of them can read it and see.
Guns N' Roses. On their first album, there was a song regarding, it was, you know, talking about gays and niggas, and this individual song sold 7 million copies and nobody boycotted it. So what's happening?
Two wrongs don't make a right. What's happening is the lesbian and gay community is letting people know that we're not going to tolerate this kind of hatred any longer. Now, the Guns N' Roses record actually expressed dislike of lesbians and gays. What Buju Banton's record expresses is hatred and violence against lesbians and gays, and we're not putting up with that any longer.
Gay pressure groups in this country have already succeeded in getting Buju Banton dropped from this week's WOMAD festival and are demanding a complete ban on Boom Bye Bye. Some DJs have already made up their own mind.
Well, the reason why I don't play Boom Bye Bye is because it has no spiritual upliftment for me and it's not educational at all. And I don't advocate violence on my show.
But Joey is more aware than most of the different cultural attitudes towards homosexuality in Britain and Jamaica.
Growing up in the Caribbean, you don't see things like that. Man with man, woman with woman. So when you come over to the Western Hemisphere, you know, you've got a place like America and Britain, and you see those sort of things, you think it's really morally wrong. So you don't get involved in it at all. And, you know, Jamaican culture, or Caribbean culture especially, they express themselves through music, and that's why tunes like that came out.
But as Buju Banton finalises a major record deal in America and prepares to tour the UK, it's clear that the harsh glare of international press attention has forced him to reconsider his ill-chosen rhymes.
I just know about Jamaica because I was born here, I wasn't born abroad, so I talk about things that I see happening in my environment then. But then again, if it caused any controversy, I know it caused some controversy, I apologize. I'm not one to condone violence. Okay?
Hey, if you say so, Buju, but maybe next time you should think before you chat a load of rap.
He's probably the nicest bloke in the world to talk to. Perhaps he should talk to some of the gay community.
Shabba, are you a Buju Banton fan? What did you think of that piece?
Well, most definitely right now, I'm out of Jamaica and I'll be on the supporting side where all Jamaicans be concerned are people with progress. Well, within this world, you know, people be living the way they feel like they want to live. And if you don't have a free will to move about, you got freedom of speech, freedom of opinion.
But he's got freedom of speech, but his freedom of speech is saying go and shoot gay people. Surely that's wrong.
Well, most definitely right now, from a forfeit the law of God Almighty, you deserve crucifixion. Most definitely. The Bible, I live by the concept of the Bible, which is the righteousness of every human being. And the Bible stated that man should multiply. The multiplication is done by a male and a female.
That's absolute crap, and you know it.
You two go and sit down, we're going to see what Katie's doing, because this has all gone completely mad.